All right, guys, God bless you and welcome to This Is It, 4321 Before the Fire, guys. Interesting. I just had a little power failure. Okay, guys, listen, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a 7-minute video, but the point of this video is not the seven minute video that I'm going to start with. The point is just to refresh your memory, because now I'm going to show you there was this thing called the coronavirus. Corona means crown. And then after the coronavirus was around and they decided it was this big, bad, evil monster that had to be taken care of and everybody had to be inoculated against it, they came up with this thing and they called it, COVID-19. That was the new one. And then after that, they said, look at this new variant that's come out. It's called Discordia. Eris, E-R-I-S, Discordia. And then after that, they said, you know what? There's another variant of this thing. We're going to call it Flirt with all the letters capital, F-L capital, but the I lowercase, and then the R and the T capital. I'm going to show you why. And then, oh, you know what? There's another variant, and it's called KP3, which means Bama. Now, I'm going to show you all those different variants in a row together and the spiritual significance. And if you guys want to know where you're at in world history, just watch this video. You'll know you're at the end. And then at the end of all that, I want you guys, I have a little trepidation wanting to play this video. I have, it's called Operation Snow Globe. Now, remember I told you what the Lord had conveyed to me, all the flat earthers were freaking out. And I was like, everybody chill out. You know, you're getting sidetracked. And the Lord conveyed to me that the whole system was like a double-sided snow globe. That's what he had conveyed to me, and he had proven it. And I did videos on it, and I showed you some guy from like Illuminati guy drawing the thing out to the students, you know, the new proselytes, and it some guy went in and he videotaped it without them knowing. I'm like, well, there you go. That's exactly what I've been telling everybody. And that's the same information they're handing out to all the Illuminati guys. It's a double-sided snow globe. So there's this thing called Operation Snow Globe, where Hillary Clinton was bribed $18 million by the FBI in order to control her, because she was supposed to win the presidency after Obama, and that $18 million bribe that she took was going to be the way to control her during her 8 years of presidency after Obama, and then after that, Michelle Obama would be rolled in. That's what Operation Snow Globe's all about. Now, I had the interview from the guy that was the Fed that was involved in the whole thing, and he's giving his testimony like a whistleblower. But instead of me playing that segment during this video, at the end of the video, I'm going to show you guys, here's the link. Just go press the button and listen yourself, because I don't want the Operation Snow Globe thing as part of this video, because they may use that as a reason to take this video down. And what I'm going to show you in this video is too important that you see the spiritual significance of all the different variants and the meanings of the names and the biblical connotations of this alleged, you know, no big deal virus that everybody in the world had to be inoculated from, remember? Okay, and now everyone's finding out it doesn't even keep you from getting it, and that all the stuff that we found out was a bunch of nonsense. But hey, it's too late now though, right? Can't go backwards. All right, but we can go forwards with information and truth. So let's do that. All right, so let me give you guys a 7-minute little thing that Zach and I produced a while back, just to kind of refresh your memory. So just watch this, and then we're gonna do the whole, all the different variants in a row. And I want you to see this. It's mind-boggling. It's truly mind-boggling. Okay, so here's a little shorty, 7 minutes and 17 seconds right now. Here we go.
In Genesis 1, it says the spirit of Elohim moved over the waters of the abyss. If you simply pay attention, you can tell every tree by its fruit. When you recognize that the female energy that started the host body system simply manifests itself all the time. If you're paying attention, you'll see the manifestation of the female energy coming up out of the waters. And the point is, Genesis 1 is parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis means virgin genesis, in which a reptilian, a female energy, started the host body system, and it came up out of the abyss, and it replicated itself, and it began a twin female system, and that system began to self-fertilize, which is parthenogenesis, virgin genesis.
Okay, I'd like to interrupt for a second. Now, if you guys have been paying attention to this channel, the Vatican, guys, is a snake. Do you understand how serious that is? The Vatican, one of the largest churches in the world, is built in the shape of the angel of the bottomless pit. The angel of the bottomless pit personified is the serpent race, the serpent. Okay, so the serpent race is just the personification of the angel of the abyss, personified like in a human form, is a serpent race. It's very simple. That's why they built the Vatican in the shape of a freaking snake. That's why it's birthing another snake called Audience Hall. What are the odds that two buildings are both snakes alongside each other? I mean, giant buildings and all, think of all the buildings that incorporate the whole complex. That's insane. But I've shown it to you. And I just want you to understand, see, it's hidden in plain sight, but they're counting on the fact that you are in a trance, that you're only half awake. You have to fully awake. And in order to fully awake, you turn the world upside down. You can see the truth. Then you've solved the whole equation and you're, oh, wow. And you make your plea to Christ. You know you're in a trap. You know the host body system is the forbidden fruit, and you know that you're as guilty as the Adam and Eve thing, because everyone's like, well, why should I go to hell because some guy took a bite of an apple? That doesn't make any sense, because that's not what it is. Okay, so anyway, thanks for letting me get that out. So let's just rewind just a hair and listen again. Now, this is Beowulf, by the way. This one little clip that you're about to see, her coming up from the abyss, is Beowulf. If anyone's ever watched Beowulf and you know what it's about, it's the story just repackaged. Okay, here we go. Sorry, guys. I'm just like, ah. Okay, here we go. Let's go.
If you're paying attention, you'll see the manifestation of the female energy coming up out of the waters. And the point is, Genesis 1 is parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis means virgin genesis, in which a reptilian, a female energy, started the host body system, and it came up out of the abyss, and it replicated itself, and it began a twin female system, and that system began to self-fertilize, which is parthenogenesis, virgin genesis. Once it self-fertilizes, it begins to bear young, and then the young transgender, and then the transgendered young begin to incestuously breed with the population. So you have the children having sex with the mother. In ancient Babylon, the ancient Babylonian religion, Semiramis and Nimrod, is exactly that. That ancient Babylonian religion, Semiramis, was married to her son, Nimrod. So again, it becomes very evident, the female energy coming up out of the abyss and then duplicating itself, creating a twin female system. And then what's introduced in Genesis 2 is the male energy in the form of Adam and Eve. So here is the riddle. When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman? I'll say it again. Riddle me this. When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman?
I'm going to pause that. In the image of Elohim, created he him, himself. Male and female created he them, the puppets. I'll say it again. In the image of Elohim, created he him, himself. Genesis 1:27, 1:28. In the image of Elohim, created he himself. Male and female created he them. So Elohim created a male and female puppet, but the twin female energy from the pit that's occupying those host body system, its energy. But who is it? It's Lucifer posing. That's why if you saw the Oscar awards or whatever, it showed John Cena come out naked with all these arches behind him of shadows of different characters, and it said the costume is the most important part. Think about that. Just go look it up. John Cena. Okay, so if he walked out naked, that's mocking God's angels. And you see all the silhouettes behind him of people wearing different costumes. You get it? Because, see, in the image of Elohim created he, him, male and female created he, them. They know the costume's the most important part. Most important part for what? For destroying you. The costume is the way they destroyed you. That's it. That's why in Genesis 1, when it says, let us create man in our image, the word image is illusion. Because the whole costume is an illusion. That's why John Cena walked out in front of a bunch of shadows behind him of costumes, mocking you. Okay, here we go. Let's get back to it. Ready?
When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman? I'll say it again. Riddle.
When it's the twin female energy from the pit, that's parthenogenesis, that starts the host body system.
Tell me this. When is sleeping with a man actually sleeping with a woman? And the answer is when the woman is transgendered and has formed a host body system that's male and female. However, she is the owner of the male and female transgender puppet show. So Adam and Eve coming into the system, when Eve is separated from Adam and then she is impregnated by the serpent race, it is a female energy impregnating Eve. And then Adam impregnates Eve with male energy. And then you have male and female energy within the host body system.
Okay, now I'm going to pause it there. Now you have male and female energy within the host body system. So what's the goal of Satan from the beginning? Well, I need to get that the angels of El, I will rise above the stars of El, the angels of El. I got to get them in a host body system. And he says, I will exalt my throne. The word exalt is to breed worms. To exalt his throne, to breed worms. In the flesh. That's exactly what it translates as I've shown it to you. So what's Lucifer's throne? The flesh, that he's going to be breeding worms and to arise above the stars, the angels of El. So the angels of El get in a host body, but there's a worm attached to you to the pit, and that's what takes you to the hell forever. That's what keeps a record against you forever. Until you turn back to the Lord your God, your eyes become single, your whole body becomes full of light instead of light and darkness, instead of life and death. You're tethered to death. When you cut the cord to death and you turn back to the God of life, you get eternal life. Do you get it? It's so simple, but the church has turned it into religion. Here we go.
Which is a cannibalistic system. And the female energy will cannibalize the male energy in the system. That's why you see the ancient Ouroboros throughout history. And it is the greatest riddle to ever solve or to ever understand. And it was given to me by the Lord. That is the reason I can show you from a satellite view. The Vatican is an upside down cross representing what happened to all of us. Us angels, which are male energy, are inverted.
Hey, what's up, Victor? Hey, listen, I'm too overloaded today, man. I got too many things, dude. I gotta call you later anyway.
Okay.
All right, man. All right, do your thing. I'll call you later. Okay, bye.
Energy are inverted in the system. And we are asleep in the system. That's why it says, arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. That's why the Bible says, when the Lord doth arise in you, you will despise their selam, their image. Because when you wake up, you'll go, wait a minute, it's an insect race. Because the pit, the abyss, are insects.
Oh my God.
Satan is the king of the locusts from the pit that have tails like scorpions. That's why when you see Beowulf, she comes out of the abyss and she has a tail like a scorpion. That's why when you watch these other movies, like women turning into serpents, they're turning upside down and backwards. That's why when you see Lady Gaga doing her manifesto, born this way, she's talking about this great birth in the heavens of this female mother monster. And it talks about how she split into two. But then there became a war between two energies within her. I mean, they're just coming out and saying it.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On Goat, a government-owned alien territory in space, a birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite, it was infinite. As the wombs numbered, and the mitosis of the future began. It was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal, it is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race, a race within the race of humanity, a race which bears no prejudice.
Okay, so let me ask you a question, because I told you this is all gonna go to the names of all the vaccines. A race within the race of humanity. Well, what race would that be? Well, it's the serpent race within the race of humanity that's a sheep. So you have a sheep and a serpent, right? What's the Vatican? It's a serpent. What's it doing? It's killing a sheep in the form of a bunch of angels. What about downtown Grand Junction? There's a statue of a guy hugging a girl. What is it really? It's a serpent killing a sheep. What about people drawing pictures of Jonathan Kleck? Hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you. Okay, that's super weird, but whatever. You drew a picture of me. Why'd you put a dead sheep behind my ear? Why is there a serpent eating me? Well, because, Johnny, it's a race within a race. We're hunters. We're killers. We hunt you guys all day long. That's what we do. Did you get it? Well, at the end of the cycle, so you start with the world, you start with the breeding, you start with the beginning, then you start with the solution to get you out of it, which is Adam and Eve, so Christ's spirit coming in to be able to reconcile you back to himself. So over the history of the world, what do you think is going to happen towards the end with the race within a race? Well, one race has to take over. Huh. Let's see. So the coronavirus, a crown, you know, like God's angels, coronavirus. Well, they're a virus to the serpent system, so you need to get rid of them. What's the serpent doing in the Vatican? The whole Vatican's a serpent. What's it doing? It's eating a dead sheep, which is a bunch of angels. So at the end of the cycle, the serpent's going to want to get rid of any sheep left in the system. What sheep? I'm glad you asked. It's male energy from above. Our Father, the Father of spirits, Father of lights. The earth is the flesh, is the temporal zone. It's the flesh zone. It's the physical zone. It's what gets you trapped. It's what gets your essence trapped in it. And then you think this is all there is until you invert the world and you see the truth. You turn the whole world upside down. You're like, oh my God, what am I doing here? You'll realize the whole thing was a trap. The whole thing's a trap. Okay, so now let's finish watching this. I won't jump in and comment anymore. Then I'm going to show you the names of all the different variants and how they're all biblical and they all have to do with killing sheep. I wonder what the odds are on that, since the Vatican's a snake killing the sheep, since downtown Grand Junction is a statue of a guy hugging a girl killing sheep, since my wife gave me a card and it's really a serpent killing the sheep, since people draw pictures of me and say, hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you, and it's really a serpent killing the sheep, since a hieroglyph in Guatemala, you turn it upside down, is really a sheep being killed by a serpent, since there's a hieroglyph in ancient Egypt of Akhenaten and Nefertiti, and it's really serpents killing sheep, which are hybrid kids that the pharaoh is holding, Akhenaten's holding his own own kid, and it's got a dead sheep in the kid's head and a reptile taking over his brain. Okay, it's pretty obvious at this point. It's a serpent sheep slaughter that's going on. Isn't that wild that the letter C, A, B, C, three in the Bible means angel of the abyss, which is Satan personified, which is the serpent? So C in the Bible, the number three, A, B, C, means the angel of the abyss, which is rising out of the abyss, personified. The word Ovid happens to mean sheep in Latin, which is what they sing all their masses in inside the big snake. They sing them in Latin. A lot of the masses, they'll do midnight mass, and then the ones where they're singing to Lucifer, donning his own creation, they do it in Latin because they don't want everyone that's not part of the club to know what's really going on. So, serpent slaughtering sheep, C, A, B, C, serpent. In the Bible, the number three is angel of the abyss personified, which is the serpent. The word Ovid means sheep, and the number 19 in the Bible means slaughter. That's exactly what the Vatican is. It's a serpent slaughtering a sheep. Why did they come out with their own coin? Who needs a coin to commemorate everybody getting one of these? I mean, who needs a coin? Oh, let's make a coin showing everybody get one. What are the odds that there's a girl standing on both sides of a guy? Okay, do you understand it's solved now, right? This whole thing is solved too. Okay, sorry. I'm just like, okay. Yeah, there's a lot going on and it's blowing my mind. We're at the door, guys. We're at the door of the end of the world and the return of Christ to grab the bride. But here's the other thing. Guys, you got to be able to, when he shows up, you don't want to have unconfessed sin on you. So if you're doing something that you haven't cleared with the Lord, or you're not even sure about, like some people think smoking, oh, I'm smoking. So the Bible says all things are permissible, not all things are expedient. So just between you and the Lord, make sure you have everything settled. That's it. Okay, here we go.
And the mitosis of the future began. It was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal. It is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race. A race within the race of humanity, a race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place, the birth of evil. And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between.
As she herself split into. Do you know how much twin female stuff is in these folders, guys? Yes. Okay.
Two ultimate forces. The pendulum of choice began its dance. To gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good.
Okay, I'm sorry I interrupted. Does that seem right to you to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good? It seems like it's easier to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards evil. Like the world, you don't have to teach a little kid how to lie, cheat, or steal. It comes from the inbredness. The two different spiritual beings at war. Where do you think it comes from? Remember in the folder I showed you guys, they said they're giving praise to Allah who split the seed and created man. Allah to rise from the abyss. Allah. And by the way, I showed you Allah. It's in the show notes. Also, it means Allah. Al means the, and La is the God. But what God is it? I showed you also it's associated with Elohim, like Genesis 1, Allah.
But she wondered, how can I protect something so perfect without evil? It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Just put your paws up, because you were born this way, baby.
So, if you can't see it, then you haven't been awakened. The Bible says, arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, because the host body system is the dead, and the living are in amongst the dead walking around. You're half dead, you're half alive. But when you get inverted, you're converted in Christ and you accept Christ, then you're fully alive. Your eyes have become single and you've been repaired and you are ready to leave when your body dies and return to your creator. Think of the original state of Adam and Eve before there was any split and they were in harmony together. So arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, and Christ will give you light.
Okay, there it is. Thank you for just letting me put that out. I just wanted to make sure that was in there, at least part of some of those concepts that you guys got to see it. Okay, now let's open up the folder and let's do this, okay? There's a new folder. All right, and let's just start with the reality that there's just a commonly held belief that angelic beings have crowns, because the Bible says, and they cast their crowns before their king. There's a band called We'll Be Casting Crowns, or a band called Casting Crowns, because we know that in the Bible they get down and they cast their crowns before the Lord, giving thanks to the one that saved them. So angelic beings from heaven have crowns. Well, if there's a virus called the crown virus, coronavirus, they're saying the ones that have the crown are the virus. You know, like the first Matrix, where Morpheus is being grilled by Agent Smith, he goes, you know, you're like a virus and we're the cure. Same exact concept. So they are going to wash out anything that's got a crown, any male energy that's in the system, they want it gone. And you will either have to submit to their race of beings, the serpent race, or they don't want you here. That's it. That's what's going on. So I put a picture here of a little lamb. Behold the Lamb of God, which takes away the sins of the world. And it's pretty profound picture of a little lamb wearing a crown of thorns, because the Lord himself was willing to come in and get us and to be born in the likeness of sinful flesh in order to retrieve his angels that got trapped in the flesh. And so how many of you guys have heard that the future is female? The future is female. Man, I mean, if you didn't notice the Me Too movement and all the stuff going on, and how the future is female was just plugged and plugged and plugged and plugged and plugged. The future is female. But again, remember, in the system that we're in, life is up, death is down. Male is up, female is down. So if the future is female, what does that mean? It means the future is death. So death is going to rise from the pit. Twin female energy will rise from the pit and take over the host body system. Death is an entity. The angel of the abyss is an entity, and he will take over the entire system through that twin female energy consuming the male energy. And if you are one, if you're like I was, where you have one up and one down and you're in between, you haven't made your conversion yet, they're going to try and stop you. They don't want you to be able to get turned up and have Christ stand up in the middle of you and the resurrection to happen inside of you. And then you're waiting for your Lord from heaven the second time. They don't want you to get converted. They want to keep you in this trap. That's the goal. So, coronavirus. What was the next one? Don't forget, the future is female. So that means the future is death. Let's look at it. Okay, let me go to the folder. Okay, so here we go with all these girls that have like a skeleton face tattooed on the back of their hands. and they're female. The future is female. Do you get it? The future is death. Female is down. Okay. And how did Lucifer say he would exalt his throne above? How did he say he would take out the princes of El, the Almighty God, through the flesh? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. The word ascend is Allah. I will Allah into heaven. I will exalt. The word exalt right here is breed worms. I will breed worms. My throne, the flesh, above the stars, the angels of El, the Almighty God. So right there, there it is in the scriptures, how we will do it. And then here it is in a Justin Timberlake video, no more angels down on the dance floor. So how are you going to do it? Well, we're going to get an angel in a body, and then he's going to have his own doppelganger inside of him, good and evil. And then the evil one's going to kill the good one by getting him in the trap with the female cannibalistic system. And here it is right in front of you. Right here in a Justin Timberlake video called No More Angels Down on the Dance Floor. Because this is what happens to angels. They get destroyed because the host body system is attached to the pit by a worm feeding off you your whole life through one of your eyes. That's why you see it in the movies like Prometheus, the guy with the eye, the worm in his one eye. You'll see it over and over again. In the Ozzy Osbourne video, Patient Number 9. I'll show it to you. Okay, here we go. So now we have this thing called the coronavirus. It's a virus to them. To who? To the female energy. Male energy is in the crown from heaven. That's a virus to the female system. We want it out. Okay, so we'll do it by starting a host body system, and we will use a worm to destroy you, basically your own reflection. Here is a worm or an insect hatching from a pupa, and its reflection is human. Exactly correct. That's a $20 silver piece from Canada. Why is there an insect that's hatching out of a pupa with his reflection that's human? And they'll try and tell you, oh, this is some little boy's head. Nonsense. It's an insect hatching out of a pupa. I can see it. Let's talk about patient number 9. Allah, are they rising? Yes. Allah, what is it? Twin female. Where is it coming from? The pit. What's it making? Well, let's see. It's coming together. Two females are coming together into one with a bow, and the bow becomes a serpent. Okay, again, Allah, to rise, out of I will arise, Allah, and then above the stars of El. How? By getting in a host body with them, feeding a worm in the pit. And then it becomes the serpent. There's the serpent race tied together with a bow. Okay, there it is, right in front of you. Empirical data. Here it is in the video, patient number 9. You know what? I'm just going to dial it down. I'm just so frustrated. I want everyone in the world to wake up, guys. I mean, right now, I just don't know what to do to tell the world. Do you guys understand? This is a serpent takeover from the pit through the host body system. It's pretty big stuff, and the Olympics is seriously tied into it. Here we go. You see the number 326 right here? Right when he opens his eye, there's a dead guy in an operating room. Look what's in the center of the thigh. He wakes up. Oh, this is, you're coming to life again. Well, what is that? Well, let me see. It's one of these. Well, if the angel of the abyss is coming to life through the whole host body system, he's reviving again, right? He's like, come, I'm alive again. He was in the pit, but he's coming out of the pit. You see the number 326? I heard the Lord tell me, look at the moment the eye opens. And I was like, okay, it's 326. Look that up in the Bible. 326 means to come to life again, revive, regain life. I regain life. So the eye opening up right there exactly at 326 happens to mean to come alive again, to revive. Who's reviving? The angel of the abyss is reviving in the host body system, taking over. There it is. More empirical data. Okay, now let's keep going. Okay, patient number 9, all about getting your stab. Okay, now, just A Job scripture. For the morning is to them even as the shadow of death. If one know them, they are in terrors of the shadow of death. It says shade of death, and it goes back to Genesis 1. Let us create man in our image. The word image means to shade, to make darker. Okay, I just put it in there as a reminder. Okay, now, in Egyptian iconography, this is Mut. Mut means mother. It's got twin serpents right here. And you see those little circles on top of the head representing eggs, female eggs. 1, 2. Ready? Mut means mother goddess. It means mother in ancient Egyptian. She was considered a primal deity associated with the waters from which everything was born through Parthenogenesis, which is exactly Ozzy Osbourne's video, Parthenogenesis, coming up from the pit, starting the serpent system, which is exactly what the Vatican is. Okay, there's no way that's possible. It's not even remotely possible. The license plate here on the car that Justin Timberlake gets in, there's no way that it's a coincidence. You guys go to the folder and look at the numbers that are on the license plate. I want to keep this video shorter. Here is Prometheus right here. The guy's eye, there's a worm in his eye. He's been affected. Now, here's the reality of life. One of your eyes, that's a dimensional trough. That in you is a dimensional trough that goes to your own worm that's feeding off you. That's why in the Vatican, when you put this guy in the slave collar right here, this is in the Vatican. I'm going to show you that the collar, I'm going to move it up. The collar is the beast. There's the eye, nose, fang, open mouth. So the slave collar, the system that you're in, that you're a slave to, is called the beast system. There it is. And that represents you, the angelic you. And when you invert it, it's an insect flying out of the pit. There's the eye, there's the mandibles, and the yellow are the wings, and the long hair makes the movement of the wind under the wings. And here is an insect flying out of the pit. So in the Vatican, the big snake, there's the agenda. Get them in the beast system, which is the host body system. They have their own, one of their eyes is attached to the pit, and when you invert them, they become a locust from the pit. This is empirical data, so it's not arguable. It's right in front of our face. Now here is, in the Vatican, the corners of the altar, the whole thing is the face of a dragon. I can show you the eye right here, the slit in the eye right here. If you look right here, there's one eye. Here's the other eye in red. There's the other eye in red. I did it like this so you could see 2X. See XX female. XX female with the guy in the middle. Monkey in the middle. Female. Guy. Female. That's the trap that we're all in. And that's her system. That's why when I reduce it in size, this whole thing turns into the Queen of Heaven. That being the eye. Eye, mouth. This is her face, like she's wearing a bonnet, and the whole thing is the head of a dragon with its mouth open. Okay, that's what it is. It's also a locust. So now we have all this data pouring in. Look at the data. Here is the coin they made. The guys that have that same papal regalia on the canopy, and the word canopy means flesh in the Bible, right here, the word flesh means canopy. In the Vatican, on the corner of their canopy, they have a locust, they have a dragon, and the Queen of Heaven. And it's got a guy in the middle of two females. Here is a coin with a guy in the middle of two females. See the X? It's no different than Dos Equis beer. It's the same exact thing. Let me read to you something very fascinating I read. Wow, bombshell claims from La Quinta Colombia. After scientifically observing what they called these things, under the microscope, La Quinta Colombia concludes humans been injected what they are calling a liquid interface of a massive implantation of the human species by another species, which they suggest are thus demons, which is right. They have compared an implant inside a person who has experienced a abduction phenomena and the blank thing contents found the components to be the same. The aim is to have control over the human head and central nervous system because it leads to, and I quote, it leads to, and I quote, that right there. Okay? Now that you saw that, let's talk about the variants. There's one that came out called Eris. And that word, you know, demonic possession, it's right here in the variant Eris. Watch. Okay, so here we go. Let's do one picture real quick before we do Eris. But let me show you just the compilation. Here's Ozzy Osbourne, twin female right here, forming the serpent. Here is the Women's March in Austin, twin female. These two women dressed as vaginas, and when they were asked, how long did it take you to make your costumes? They said, one of them said, since the beginning of time. Here is the coin, female on both sides of a male. Here is the Bud Light commercial, two twin females with Ian in the middle as a sacrifice. Here is the Vatican, parthenogenesis, the serpent system rising from the abyss right here. Here is the Dos Equis guy in between two girls, and if you look at this, you'll see that the lion is painted on these two people sitting behind him. I believe it's two females. So there's the head of a lion, but when you really zoom out, squint your eyes a little bit, you can tell this whole thing is a sheep. See it? That's right here is the horn of the sheep. That's the other horn of the sheep. That's the eye of the sheep up in there, eye of the sheep. And this is the nose of the sheep. That's a bighorn sheep right there. Why are they disguising a bighorn sheep right behind this guy? And why are they putting him in between these two girls? Well, it's no different than the coin, is it? It's identical to the coin because that's the agenda. Now, keep going. Let's go to the idea of an apple in a magnetic field. Here is a male inside a magnetic field and a female inside a magnetic field. And if they intersect, well, then there's an intersection between these two and you become locked into that system. Now, the idea of an apple. Let's look at that. Here's a man standing and here's a magnetic field coming out of his head and going in the bottom. See it? Okay, now, watch this. Let's look at, this is the name of the one of the variants. It's called Eris. She's holding an apple with a K and it stands for Callisti. And she is the goddess of discord and strife. Look, Eris, Olympian. This is her name in Olympian. It's kind of funny, Ipa in Olympian reminds me of the Simpsons episode. It says, whatever this is in Olympian is the Greek goddess of discord and strife holding the apple. You know, like allegedly there was this, churches tell you there was this apple. The word apple is nowhere in the Bible. It never says anything about an apple. The host body system is a forbidden fruit. That's what you don't get involved in. If you get involved in it, then you're trapped in it. Then you got to be redeemed from it because it is a destructive machine. It will destroy you. Now, here you go. Watch. Let's look at who Eris is. Eris was the goddess personified spirit Dalmona of strife. So, you see this word, personified spirit, that means Damona, which means demon, by the way. The goddess of personified spirit, Damona, of strife, discord, contention, and rivalry. She was often portrayed more specifically as the Damona of strife, of war, haunting the battlefield and delighting in human bloodshed. Because of Eris's disagreeable nature, she was the only goddess not to be invited to the wedding of Peleus and Thetis. When she turned up anyway and was refused admittance, she raged and threw a golden apple amongst the goddesses inscribed to the fairest. Three laid claim to it, Hera, Aphrodite, and Athena, and in their rivalry brought about the events leading to the Trojan War. Okay, so here's a quick thing on who is Eris. That is the name of one of the newest forms of the mutations of the coronavirus. Now, remember, it was corona, which means crown, and then it became COVID-19, which is serpent sheep slaughter, which is exactly what the Vatican is. It's a serpent slaughtering a sheep. And then we have Eris, which is the goddess, the demon of discord. That's the name. Here we go, and let me show it to you. Let me show you this real quick. The new variant is Eris. See it right there? And what you need to know about it. So here are the symptoms of Eris. Why would you name the subsequent, you know, alleged mutated virus? Why would you name it Eris? The goddess demon of discord and strife. That's kind of weird. Okay, but that's what they named it. Just go look it up if you don't believe me. Now watch this. Let's look at this word real quick. The daemons or daemoness were spirits in Greek mythology which served as personifications of various concepts such as love, darkness, or justice. The Greek word is sometimes spelled today as demon or daemon. But unlike the demons of Christianity, daemons were not necessarily malevolent entities, but it's a demon. So that's their own words. Okay, now let me show you Eris holding. Let's see, I'll pull it up. Here is Eris, and she's holding this apple all the time. It says Khaleesi on it, and I don't want to get into a whole thing of Khaleesi, but you should go look it up. And then let me show you another manifestation of the apple, because I thought it was fascinating. Here is another manifestation of the apple, Khaleesi. You see, there's the apple. Now, remember, this is all associated with the variant of COVID? That's insane. That's not even possible. But look. So here's a serpent eating its own tail. See it? There's the apple on one side, and there is the five-pointed star on the other side. That represents the angel, the angelic being in the trap with the apple. See it? With the goddess of discord and strife, because you wanted it. You wanted it, you got it. Now let me just give you another example of that. There you go. Lynn, instead of making it the apple, let me just make it, see the raptor that's upside down? Cain, child of the serpent, and Abel, the child of Adam. Cain and Abel, cannibal, there it is, cannibalistic system. It's all perfect information. One more time with Eris. Eris, ancient Greek, means strife, the goddess of chaos, strife, and discord. She would start by making the city's citizens paranoid. Now tell me if this is starting to sound familiar. She would start by making a city's citizens paranoid and petty, having them turn on each other. Then during the infighting, Ares would arrive, usually with his armies, to siege the weakened city and burn it to the ground. Her name is being translated into Latin as Discordia, which means discord. There it is. Okay, evil doer. Evil doer. Okay, there you go. I mean, that's the name of one of the variants, guys. So why would you name one of the variants that? Okay, now let's move on to the next one. It says new COVID variants, Eris and BA2.86 is one scarier than the other. Know the difference. Okay, now, I'm not going to get into the other one yet, but I'll get into this one called Flirt. Okay, now another one comes out, and they say KP3 is a part of a trio known as Flirt. Capital F, capital L, little I, capital R, capital T. This is the way the serpent race, does things. These are variants, and they just surpassed the fellow Flirt variant. KP2 is the most common 19 strain in America, according to data from these guys. Okay, ready? Let's break that down. F and the L together. F, A, B, C, D, E, F is 6, 12. A band, bonds, chains. Okay, so the F and the L together is 612, and 612 means a band, a bond, chains, jail. So this was to establish chains within you. Chains to hold you in bondage so you can't get out of this. They don't want you to get out of that. Because if they put a modem right here, they put a little chip that controls that, then you become an antenna. And if you take it, you're guaranteed eternal torment. Okay, here we go. It says bonds, chains, and jail. Yes or no? Does 612, F and the L together, does it say bonds, chains, yes, jail? What about the letter I, which is little? What's that mean? A lost thing, like one of God's lost sheep. A lost thing, something that was lost. Lost. Like Jesus going out and looking for his lost sheep. So let's see, put in chains, a lost thing, and then what are then R and the T. So R is 18 and T is 20. And it means to cease, to cause deceive, cease, to cut off, to destroy. To completely cut off, destroy, destroyed, perish, ruined, silenced, unceasingly. Now I'm asking you, yes or no, does this guy Jonathan Kleck, has he nailed it? Has he caught the serpent race destroying all the sheep within the system? It's a yes or no. Either you see it or you don't. If you don't see it, then I love you in Christ. You're not awake then. Because this is stupid. It's not even obvious. It's stupid obvious. It's retarded obvious. Okay, there it is. That's what it was used for. So they can completely cut off by putting that which is lost in chains. I'll say the words. The R and the T. R and the T. 1820. Completely cut off. The letter I is a lost thing. And then the R and the F and the L, 618, means to put in chains. Okay, there you go. It's not even arguable. There it is. Okay, what about this thing that came out? Remember? Wow, all of a sudden it's turning blue. Well, I've always maintained that the color for the serpent race, they use blue all the time. So do different political parties, the color blue. Blue is blood that has no life in it. Red blood has life in it. Blue blood doesn't have, it has no eye, it's unoxygenated. I'm sorry. Also, scorpions have blue blood. Have you ever noticed that the Illuminati or all the secret societies, they like to use scorpions, and then they like to use the octopus as having many tentacles. Did you know also octopus and creatures like that have blue blood? Yep, it's because it has, I think, copper in it. Anyway, so here we go. It's all turning blue. It used to be red. Why is it turning blue? It says KP3 is the new variant. What you need to know about that? Well, why is Katy Perry doing some video talking about the future is only female? Instead of men at work, it's women at work. And so she's holding up this big light, or this big white female symbol, and she's got KP. She's got KP on her thing. And watch this. KP, if you do KP in the Bible, K is 11. K is 11. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. L, M, N, O, P. So 11, 16. KP, yes or no? K. 11 P16. What's 11 16 in the Bible? Let's see. It's Bama. I will ascend above the heights, the Bama of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. I will Allah. The word ascend is Allah. So the angel of the bottomless pit, just like the twin females in the Ozzy Osbourne video, they're ascending out of the bottomless pit. I will ascend Allah, twin female energy, which is who? Satan. Lucifer, I will ascend above the heights, Bama, of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. And it just so happens that the new variant happens to be KP, and then 3 means angel of the abyss. Okay. Angel, A, B, C. Angel of the abyss, which is the serpent personified. Do you understand there's no way to hit all these data points? It's not even remotely possible without it being totally true. So now the new variant is called KP Bama 3. Angel of the Abyss, rising. Allah, I will rise. Allah, above the heights. Bama, and then KP3 is the Angel of the Abyss. it's like a language, guys. It's easy to read once you, well, the Lord taught it to me. But anyway, now, this is what I freaked out on the other day, because I was like, there's no way. I heard the Lord tell me to look up this serpent sheep slaughter with the number 240. And I typed it into Google, and I was like, wow, that's crazy. It brought up this task force that's with the Nevada National Guard, and it says, down with the sickness. Oh, now you want to see this out. That's a bighorn sheep, isn't it? Down with the sickness. What sickness are y'all talking about? That's the sickness they're talking about. That is the sickness they're talking about, the coronavirus. That's the sickness. And now you have their little patch on the Nevada National Guard, which is crazy, because that's, you know, that this takes it to a whole new level. And look at what Nevada Army Guard Joint Force Headquarters, look at what their thing is on their uniforms. Above the rest, I will arise above the angels of El. And here is a star rising from the down here. And look, it makes an X. And look at the X right here. See, there's an X right here. And this makes a big X, no different than Madonna. Madonna had a big X on her chest and an X on her eye. This is identical. It's two different plants. And I will arise above the stars of El. There it is in a patch. And I can see it, and I can read it, and I can tell you this is happening now. Okay, now, let's look at who started this whole place. Okay, now watch this. Ready? You've seen these guys, the Square and Compass. You know, they're all the secret societies and the Freemasons. It says, a builder, a creator, a Demos, a unified group, you know, like Demos, like Discordia, Demo, see it? Demo, Demos, a unified group of people, but Demos, you see the square and compass? What's it on? 5, 10, 11, 12. So there's 12, 5, 10, 15, 16, 17, 12, 17. Wow, 12, 17 in the Bible, which is what the square and compass on happens to mean a unified group, Demos. And they want to get rid of all the crown virus. No more crown virus. No more sheep. Sheep got to go. Everyone's got to be mean. Everyone's got to be hateful. Everyone's got to be cruel. No goodwill towards men. Let's get all those guys out of here. They don't belong here. That's what's going on. It's called Satan's rule on earth. Okay, now, back to the folders. If you guys will go look at these folders and look at what's in here. And look how everything's been laid out for you. The word Allah is standard Arabic word for God. It means Al means all right here. Al means the, and then La means God, the God. But down here, it's traced back to earliest Semitic writings, and it intersects the word, Hebrew word for Elohim. See it? Elohim, for God. So who split the seed and created man? Well, if we go to Genesis, and we go, I'm going to go to Genesis right now. If we go to Genesis during the formation of man, that is a seed being split into male and female, isn't it? Sure looks like it to me. Let's go here. So Genesis 1:26, let us make man in our image. So in the image of Elohim created he him. Here's the word image. It means to shade, a phantom. To shade, like Justin Timberlake putting on his shades. A phantom, that is an illusion. And then a representative figure, especially an idol. That's what the word image means. So in the image of Elohim, right here, Elohim, just like I showed you with Allah, in the image of Elohim, Allah, created he him, male and female, male and female created in them. They're splitting the seed, male and female. And now let's look at the Vatican. Inside the Vatican, well, wait a minute. Isn't that chair, doesn't it become a penis and all the angels are melting into semen? It's either you see it or you don't. It's like, yeah, that's what it is. It says in the Bible, Isaiah 43, right there, it's when you cross through the waters, I will be with you. The word cross through the waters means when you cross to the other side in copulation in the semen, I will be with you. So here is a big picture of a lot of tongues sticking out. Just like, see the dead sheep, Rolling Stones, dead sheep, this guy with his tongue sticking out, and the big dead sheep with its tongue sticking out, and people laying on the floor facing opposite directions, worshiping that. Well, here it is. You turn it upside down, and it becomes female. So yes or no? Right side up, it's male. Upside down, it's female. Right side up. Right side up. Right side up, the whole thing is male reproductive system. Upside down, it's female. And does it say, I believe this is the Hadith, O people, interconnect and be pious and kind to each other by him who has split the seed and created man. And it says, he appears to you like the sun. Well, I know that Obama's logo is the sun rising. That's what it is. So, I mean, that would suggest that's what it is. And then, next question, yes or no? Are these heterogenetic? So if this is a penis right here, and we put Baphomet the goat god sitting right on the chair. So if that's a penis, and then that's a vagina, so you have male and female. So we took the image of the virgin, and we turned it upside down. That's a dead sheep, and then that's the virgin. So you have male and female reproductive systems in this one big sheep that's an altar, yes or no? The answer is like, obviously. Okay, well, does it say in the Bible that God's people are a people that is robbed and spoiled, all of them snared in holes? They are hid in prison houses. And the word hid in prison houses means, in the sense of separation, two heterogeneities, diverse seeds, mingled seed, yes or no? So there's the Bible. This is what happened to God's people. They got trapped in heterogenetic prison houses. That's where God's people are trapped. That's what it says. And then yes or no, is this big dead sheep a heterogenetic prison house? Yes or no? That's all it is. Here's the resolution to the system. There's an angel you that's trapped in there with the demon you. One goes up, one goes down, and then the reconciliation in the middle is Christ on the cross, reconciling both to God through the cross, making one new man between the angel and the demon that are at war within you. And Christ will reconcile both of them. If you don't take Christ on the cross, this remains your condition, and that goes to the pit. And let me show you a really good tattoo this guy has that just shows how obvious it is. Here it is. Watch this. Here's a really cool image we made for you. Here's the demon part of the tattoo. It makes a scrotum and a penis. We put it right up here. Here's the angelic part of you. He's screaming to get out. We put it right up here. So one cross represents this part of you. The other cross represents the other part of you. And then the guy down in the pit waiting to get fed off that system is Satan. He gets fed off that system. And the only way to fix that system is Christ in the middle. That's it. And now they're rolling out these things, and they're going to come up with another variant, I guarantee it. And they're going to demonize anyone that doesn't want to do these things. They will say, you're evil. You don't care about everyone. Because in their eyes, you are the disease. Solved. Done. And I'm not going to not speak out. Now, there is a video I want y'all to watch. And you need to see it. By the way, I would like to even read you this video that I just did, but with more detail. But I want you guys to go watch this. See right here? Operation Snow Globe. I bribed Hillary Clinton $18 million right here. Go watch this. Go watch that. It's in the folder. Now let me show you how to, you know what? I'll add this as a link right here. You guys go watch that yourself. Okay, I love you guys in Christ. I'm I'm under beyond maximum pressure right now. I've got more stuff than most people can even imagine. Keep all of us here in your prayers. We have come under massive, massive attack. And it's hitting pretty close to home. It's just, Satan doesn't want me to continue to show you this stuff. He is really getting pissed at me showing this to you. So anyway, just keep us going. Help us keep moving forward. And we will walk this out to the end. I told you, my ministry was to bear witness to the destruction of the temple, which is the host body system. So I'm bearing witness, like in Matthew 24, Luke 21, Mark 13, to the destruction of the temple. Surely there shall not be one stone left upon another. Jesus said, do you see all these things? Have you noticed there's a personal pronoun problem in the world? People don't know if they're a he, a she, or, you know, another 150 other permutations of whatever that is. Let me show you a word in the Bible that should change everything in the way you think about that. Ready? So when Jesus came out of the, departed from the temple, and that's very profound there too, because he is going to depart from the temple completely, and he will not be around in the future that's coming up. He departed from the temple. His disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said unto them, see ye not all these things? See the word things? He didn't say buildings. He said things. And the word things is tauta, tota, and it's these things, these, they, those, thus, and it's personal pronouns. He, she, or it, that is this or that, hereof, it, she, the same, this man, this same, this woman. He said, see all these things. He, she, it, man, female, man, woman. I say to you, there shall not here be one stone left upon another that shall not be thrown down. Kata lu, kata, to throw down, to break up and to dissolve. Ready? To break, especially to sunder by separation of the parts, to cut into pieces. Do y'all understand this is the destruction of the temple, and that this thing is a huge part of the destruction of the temple? This is absolutely necessary in order to do it. Now you know. You don't name a variant, you don't have a crown virus, and then you name it serpent sheep slaughter, and then you name it Eris Discordia, the demon goddess of discord, and then you name it Bama, there's another one. What was the other one? Oh, then you name it flirt, which means to put in bonds that which is lost for complete destruction. And then you name it Bama? KP3? No. No, 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 no. We're there. We're arriving. All right. I love you guys in Christ. Now, peace and grace to everybody. Keep walking it out to the end. Everybody's got their own walk. And you have to just keep going and do the best you can. Love everyone you can. Love covers a multitude of sins. And try and love everybody and be kind to everybody, even when they're not being kind to you. I know it's not easy, but that's us. That's who we are. All right. Let's do a hug. There you go. That represents you. This is Johnny. I love you in Christ.
Oh, my goodness.
The end of the world's here. All right. Don't forget, all the bombings are printed on your U.S. currency notes, and I have folders in the show notes that show you all that. Make sure you go watch the snow globe thing. Okay.